The evidence is mounting that greater economic equality benefits all people in all societies. Despite this, inequality is soaring. Have you ever wondered why? Most people blame capitalism for the growing inequality and disparity we see in our world today. But it wasn't always like this. Capitalism has been here for hundreds of years and has lifted most of the world out of poverty. All material improvements in people's everyday life can be ascribed to this system. However, capitalism has been crumbling after we introduced our current monetary system. To understand why, we need to go back to 1971, when we replaced the gold standard with our current monetary system, called the fiat system. Historically, the gold standard governed how much money could be created. Before the gold standard was abolished, the global debt was at 100% of GDP. In other words, only money that was first earned could be lent out. Seems reasonable, right? When we got rid of the gold standard, however, banks were allowed to lend money that was never earned by the economy. This made it possible to create more money than economic growth and causes what we refer to as inflation, where prices increase, but no real value is added. The excess money created by banks inflates prices, but does not create economic growth. The fiat system was by many considered illegitimate at first, because there was no longer a link between money and real value. Some argue that inflation stimulates economic growth, but 50 years of testing has shown us the opposite. Economic growth has declined steadfastly and now is about half of what it used to be before the gold standard was abolished. One of the reasons for this is the way inflation is brought about. Rather than printing the excess money and giving it away, governments instead gave banks permission to lend it. The excess debt creation allowed the financial sector and speculators eligible for bank credit to grow at the expense of the rest of society. The biggest problem with excess fiat money, however, is the injustice and inequality it creates. Take 2017 as an example. That year, the global GDP was $79 trillion. Debt added was a staggering $21 trillion. Economic growth, as measured by GDP, amounted to $3 trillion. That left $18 trillion in excess money for inflation. Only $2 trillion of these 18 went to inflate consumer prices, which are the only prices included in the inflation statistics. An unbelievable $16 trillion, 20% of GDP, inflated home and financial prices. As these markets are mainly limited for people who have money in the first place, they are the ones who benefit from the excess money created. A working-class family, living from paycheck to paycheck, has limited funds to invest and are not able to benefit from inflation. This is the actual reason why the working class has become poorer over the last 50 years, while the rich have become a lot richer. To summarize, the fiat system has slowed down economic growth and distributed the wealth more unequally. With its fixed supply and unpolitical nature, Bitcoin has been referred to as a viable alternative to the fiat currency system. However, Bitcoin is even more problematic than fiat currencies. If Bitcoin was money, it would lead to a general fall in the price level, what we refer to as deflation. This is due to Bitcoin's monetary base, which increases far less than economic production. When the same amount of money chases more goods and services, prices are destined to fall. When prices fall, people will hoard the currency rather than investing in anything else. This will lead to a depression and the economy breaking down. Concluding that inflation and deflation is bad leaves us with only one viable option: keeping prices stable. This is achievable by creating money at the same rate as economic growth. By linking the currency to GDP, money will be a pure representation of real value. Today, there is no real definition of money. It makes a lot of sense to tie the definition of money to the economy in order to make money understandable and trustworthy. Linking money to GDP will ensure that money goes toward productive investments, as all other prices would stabilize. This will discourage unproductive speculation and result in optimal allocation of resources, leading to the highest economic growth possible. By chance, gold production increased at approximately the same rate as the economic growth. This is the unknown reason for why the gold standard kept prices stable over time and balanced the economy. However, gold supply was unpredictable and hard to manage. Globe is a currency linked to global GDP. It was created to restore the link between money and real value. Globe is a perfection of the gold standard because its supply will never deviate from economic growth. Like gold, it will serve as an unpolitical and trustworthy world currency and a safe store of value. With its GDP link, Globe will also be a digital benchmark for national currencies and how to operate them on the basis of national GDP growth. Globe will contribute to a more equal, sustainable, and balanced world with less disparity and increased social mobility. The future of money is based on real value.